Each time a man stands up for an ideal, or acts to improve the lot of others, or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope, and crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring, those ripples build a current which can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance.
Talk to Bob Alves about his work, and he'll offer a quick string of life lessons. Snippets of common sense fly through the air, and the broad ahs of his Taunton, Massachusetts accent. You have to have heart, Bob says. You can't lie to people. You have to listen, know the person. You can't break promises. Such simplicity belies the complexity of Bob's work. He understands that reaching his participants as team leader at NeuroRestorative Rayham, Massachusetts, is an exercise in both. People come to NeuroRestorative to heal from brain and spinal cord injuries, to adjust and adapt to their transformed bodies and minds. When a new participant arrives, Bob watches. He observes. He reads a person. His goal: find a connection that leads to a relationship that leads to healing. So it was when Bob met Mike, a 35-year-old paralegal from Washington, D.C., whose life was forever changed by an oncoming car. The accident left him cognitively impaired and behaviorally challenged. Human interaction was reduced to angry verbal outbursts. So Mike retreated from the world. Bob took the time to read the articles Mike had written as a legal professional. He got to know his family and his interests. And then Bob brought him back. "I understand him," said Bob, who honed in on Mike's love of sports and music. "Mike's is a life interrupted, but I can give him a second chance." The two go for haircuts, lunches, and dinners out, even a Bob Dylan concert, something Mike's family never thought possible. His sensitivity to noise often sparks emotional outbursts. But there, in the outdoor amphitheater, during the rain, thunder, and lightning, Mike and Bob held hands to calm the effects of their surroundings. They enjoyed the music, a language they both speak so well. "Bob has reached the core of this person," offered Linda Griffith, NeuroRestorative's program manager in Rayham, and his nominator. "It's a bravery Bob has. He's willing to try anything." Bob agrees. "If it didn't work today, I'll come back tomorrow." He has a bottomless toolbox amassed over years of working through people's challenges. Bob began his human services career counseling teens with deep emotional scars and a knack for bad choices, including memberships in some of the country's toughest gangs. Humor became his most powerful tool, and respect, lots of respect. "I don't use fancy words. I say what I have to say in a respectful manner and use common sense," explained Bob. The kids reciprocated, as do Bob's current participants in Rayham. From these roots came the ability to de-escalate almost any situation, something that has become legendary at NeuroRestorative in Rayham. "Bob is honest and he follows through," said Aaron Sabine, NeuroRestorative's residential supervisor. "He is clear, he listens, he gives people answers. They know he's telling the truth. They trust him. It's a trust that leads to results." Mike is saying more words these days. He's finishing Bob's sentences when he's not singing Dylan songs. He's spending more time out of bed and in the community. He can now say, "Hi, Mom," on the daily calls to his family that Bob assists him with. and shot, Mike is regaining his life. Bob wears his achievements lightly. He shrugs off the stress that comes with the job's difficult moments. He focuses on the positive. "I love my job. It makes me feel great," said Bob. But then, the serious nature of his work bubbles to the surface. He reflects on his participants and sees himself in them. "It could have been me," he offered. "What inspires me is life. I feel like I'm on a mission to help people. It's a mission and a guy worthy of a Dylan song." "May your hands always be busy," wrote the rock bard in his iconic anthem, Forever Young. "May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of changes shift. May your heart always be joyful, and may your song always be sung. May you stay forever young. Bob, for taking on your mission with selfless grace, honesty, and good humor, for seeing beyond people's challenges to their humanity, for respecting it and tapping into it, and for offering the promised land of healing to the toughest cases in your care, I am proud to present you with the Ripple of Hope Award.